Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Unreal Engine 5.7 preview has officially been released this past week, and there's just so much to get into. This release includes a brand new built-in Unreal Engine AI assistant. We have more performance improvements, including a new nanite voxelized foliage system. We also have a brand new procedural vegetation editor for creating foliage inside of Unreal Engine, new retargeting quality of life updates, and there's just so much more. So in this video, we'll be covering over everything you need to know about the new Unreal Engine 5.7 launch, what to expect, as well as when you guys can get your hands on this release. And if you guys are new here to the channel, my name is Smart Poly. I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and content. And if you are interested in learning Unreal Engine for game development, I have some exciting news. My Unreal Engine 5 multiplayer survival game course bundle now has a 25% off limited time sale. To commemorate the launch of Unreal Engine 5.7, we're having a special 25% off discount. So use code UNREAL57 at checkout when you purchase the survival game course bundle. Get access to over 100 hours of learning content between both courses included in the single bundle and kickstart your game development journey today. So check it out, link in the description below, or head over to my website smartpoly.teachable.com to learn more. And with all that out of the way, let's get right into the video. So the biggest new feature coming to Unreal Engine 5.7 is a new nanite voxelized foliage system. Essentially, nanite foliage was introduced in 5.1, but there were a lot of issues with its initial release. Things like triangle overdraw, which is when there's a bunch of geometry showing on the screen that should be hidden, but now that it is solved with nanite voxelized foliage, instead of using triangles to render foliage from afar, we're using a new voxelized approach. That way we can not only reduce the amount of overdraw, but also allow for some more detailed foliage that wasn't possible with traditional geometry card methods. And the best showcase of this was in the Witcher 4 demo, when they showcased an entire forest made up of this pine tree, which had each individual pine needle its own separate model. Along with nanite voxelized foliage, in Unreal Engine 5.7, they also introduced a brand new procedural vegetation editor. So this is essentially like having your own speed tree built into Unreal Engine, where you can create your own types of vegetation, things like trees or different bushes. And this is using a node-based approach similar to PCG. Now the benefits of using this new procedural vegetation editor is you can just use a handful of assets, just a couple of leaves and branches, and generate a couple of different variations of trees right inside of the editor, instancing just a handful of meshes to create completely unique assets. And again, this was showcased in the Witcher 4 demo, showing that they've created this entire forest just using a few of these different assets as shown on the screen. And I've made a separate video about the procedural vegetation editor, so if you guys want to see how you can get access to the sample assets and mess around with the demo, check out the video, link in the description below. Another big feature coming to Unreal Engine 5.7 is a brand new AI assistant. So this AI assistant is sort of like a built-in ChatGPT plugin into Unreal Engine, but in this case, it's developed and deployed by Epic Games. So it's their own AI system that they've trained all the way up to, I believe, Unreal Engine version 5.6. So essentially you can ask it questions. So if you have a certain question about a particular feature or a certain setting, you can go ahead and ask it directly through there. But right now it's still very early and still experimental, so you can't really get it to generate blueprint code or ask it, you know, questions about your specific project. So it doesn't have like access to view your code in your project or to make changes to it. So we'll have to see in the future if that's going to be the case, if they're going to update this even further. And again, I have a full video documenting and showing you guys how to enable this plugin and mess around with it if you guys are interested. 5.7 also includes a bunch of major performance improvements, including improvements to the CPU. As you can see, here's a screenshot of the core engine optimizations. So the PS5 platform memory API redesign allowed us to unlock low-level hardware optimizations and gain up to 15% in CPU performance in 5.7. And they're continuing to work on more performance and memory optimizations for future UE versions. But this comes after the release of 5.6, which also included major performance improvements. So as you can see, they're just updating and working on overall performance. And this is a screenshot from one of the talks over at Unreal Fest in Sweden. So hopefully the talk will be uploaded here to YouTube here in the future. And also this user on Twitter made a nice comparison between the performance in Unreal Engine 5.5 all the way to 5.7, showing that there is overall a 18% performance improvement from 5.5 to 5.7. So again, they're just working on performance improvements, including things like the nanite voxelized foliage approach, which fixes things like the nanite triangle overdraw. There's a lot of character and animation improvements, including a brand new experimental feature for retargeting. There is a new spatially aware retargeting feature included in 5.7 that allows you to retarget animations from one character to another, but also take into account things like the character's collision. So if you have a character that has a larger body preset, you can take into account the character character's body shape so that you can modify the hand position to avoid things like the character's hands clipping through the body. And I made a separate tutorial video on this new feature, so definitely go ahead and check it out, link in the description below. Along with that, they have better foot contact and proportional retargeting, which is also just another quality of life feature. And of course, MetaHuman Creator is now supporting Linux and Mac OS. So in 5.6, they released MetaHuman Creator integrated into the engine. So to access it, you'd have to install Unreal Engine and include the MetaHuman core data. Well, now in 5.7 actually supports Linux and Mac OS, so you can create MetaHumans from inside of the engine on all these different platforms. As for the editor, we're also getting some updates to the home screen. So when you create a brand new project, we have a new home screen, so just more updates to the UI, and these are coming after the new UI updates that came in 5.6. Do you guys like the new UI updates, or is this something that you guys just absolutely hate? Let me know down in the comments down below. As for rendering, in Unreal Engine 5.7, Megalights is moving into beta, and it now supports things like directional light, Niagara particle lights, translucency, and hair strands. As for Substrate is the new material system, and it's actually now production ready and enabled by default in Unreal Engine 5.7. So if you haven't learned Substrate, now is the time, because it's actually enabled by default starting in 5.7. If you're interested in animating side of Unreal Engine, Control Rig is also receiving its fair bit of updates with world collisions for Control Rig physics. So you can have things like collision interaction with Control Rig to use existing world geometry and bring physics bodies to life by creating believable contacts, pushes, and interactions. Control Rig is also getting this new dependency view, which is just a way to visualize the different rig elements and how certain elements are dependent on each other. As for animation, animators need quick ways to access multiple selections through the process, and so they're adding these new selection sets. In other animation news, they are adding some hair art directability in Unreal Engine. As for world building and open worlds, we're getting a update to the HLOD system. So now in 5.7, they have support for custom HLODs, which means you can use a third-party program and import it directly in the engine. You can go ahead and do that. As for PCG, or the procedural content generation, it is now considered production ready in 5.7. So it's definitely come a long way since it was introduced in 5.2. as an experimental feature. And in 5.7, they have this brand new PCG editor mode. So yeah, now it has its own separate editor mode where you can switch into the editor mode and choose and assign your own PCG graph. And you can adjust all the parameters inside of this mode rather than having to do it directly in the details panel. So it's just another quality of life update. Again, they have the new procedural vegetation editor, which is also sort of like a PCG graph system. And of course, they have a ton of UX improvements and new nodes and operators added. As for platforms, there's some improvements to the mobile renderer. There's now experimental support for SMAA for the mobile renderer, as well as you can now use the multi-pass deferred rendering mode, which enables contact shadows and insert shadows. As for motion design, you're also getting some updates. In fact, they also released a new sample project, so if you guys are interested in that, you can check it out on Fab. Speaking of Fab, Fab also received some updates in 5.7, or just recently. They've now integrated Fab directly into the Unreal Engine launchers. So if you notice on the Epic Games launcher, we now have a new button for Fab. So if you click on it, it actually shows Fab integrated into the Epic Games launcher. So you no longer need to head over to the website to browse or look for assets for your project. Simulation in VFX is also getting a fair bit of updates in 5.7. Including updates to Chaos Destruction, Chaos Hair, and Chaos Fluids. But more importantly, Niagara now actually supports a brand new Nanite renderer. So there's a brand new plugin for Nanite Niagara, which allows artists to render Nanite meshes directly within Niagara particle systems, enabling a more detailed and optimized visual effects without the usual performance trade-offs. There's a couple of different framework updates. Things like State Tree is receiving a couple of new things, like a State Tree Rewind Debugger, which is a debugging track for State Tree that has a dedicated details panel with a compact tree view, making it easier to visualize and navigate complex logic setups. The mass entity system is also getting updated, including this new mass debugger. So they're introducing this new powerful entity search system integrated into the mass debugger, giving developers new UI for crafting and executing mass entity queries. Virtual production is also getting a bunch of updates to things like Live Link. They have a brand new Live Link broadcast component, new Live Link hub Unreal Editor device. and a couple updates to the mocap manager. First-person rendering is also getting updated in 5.7, is now considered production-ready, and has included support for Nanite with and without world position offset. So this just brings all the benefits of Nanite to the first-person rendering setup, meaning you can have a really detailed character model for your first-person hand and weapon with the use of Nanite, which I think will be pretty interesting to see how this will change first-person shooters. There's now new blend shapes and sculpting tools built into 5.7, which allows you to create different blend shapes, even things like morph targets inside of the engine, so you can just instantly paint and sculpt onto your character and see these updates happen in real time. But yeah, those are all the major different updates and changes coming to Unreal Engine 5.7. Let me know what you guys think about these new updates down in the comments down below. And that's pretty much it for this video, so I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.